The Surrogacy Regulation Bill 2019, Dr. Harsh Vardhan to move a motion for consideration of the Surrogacy Regulation Bill 2019.
Respected sir, I rise to move that the Surrogacy Regulation Bill 2019, as passed by Lok Sabha, be taken into consideration. Sir, I would like to briefly...
Few minutes. Brief. Be brief then. Again, we'll get chance in the last.
Pardon?
Be brief, please.
Yes, sir. Keep sure, brief. Sir. Sir, let me remind this House that as per this bill, surrogacy is defined as a practice where a woman gives birth to a child for an intending couple with the intention to hand over the child after the birth to the intending couple. It is being practiced in the country for many decades, but still there is no legislation for this. And the result is that there are malpractices associated with this. There is commercialization of surrogacy, and there is also exploitation of the surrogate mothers.
Kripya Santi Rakhe, please. Yes.
Sir, in the absence of regulation in India, India has unfortunately emerged as a surrogacy hub for couples from different countries. And as per a recent study, the reports suggest that there are somewhere like 3,000 surrogacy clinics which are operating in the country, and there are somewhere like 2,000 foreign babies which are born every year in the country. And there are plethora of reports which suggest there are huge number of unethical practices. There is exploitation of surrogate mothers. There are rackets of intermediaries in importing, exporting, and selling of human embryos as well as gametes. So why there is a need for regulation? Sir, this issue has been raised in the parliament on number of occasions since 2010, and there are about 11 parliamentary assurances already pending, 6 in the Lok Sabha and 5 in the Rajya Sabha, where the government has promised legislation on this issue. And also, sir, the 228th report of the Law Commission has recommended that the government should prohibit commercial surrogacy, and it should allow altruistic, ethical surrogacy by a suitable legislation. Sir, there was also a PIL in the Supreme Court, following which the Cabinet Secretariat in October of 2015 had asked the department to bring about a legislation, and an affidavit was also filed in the Supreme Court promising that the government shall prohibit commercial surrogacy. Then let me apprise this House about the international situation on this issue right now, sir. Sir, in most of the countries, there is either altruistic surrogacy with regulation and the commercial surrogacy is thoroughly prohibited. And if I have to name the countries where commercial surrogacy is thoroughly banned and it is considered illegal, then these countries are New Zealand, Australia, Japan, China, United Kingdom, Switzerland, France, Philippines, South Africa, Canada, Netherlands, Spain, Sweden, Germany, and most of the European countries. Recently, Thailand and Nepal also did it. It is right now only allowed in 3 places, that's in Russia, Ukraine, and the California province of USA. And surrogacy is also criminalized in a few countries. Sir, on 17th December 2015, the European Parliament passed a resolution, and I would like to apprise this House, what did they say? They condemned the practice of surrogacy, which undermines the human dignity of the woman, since her body and its reproductive functions are used as a commodity. Sir, this bill was, after this bill was framed, it was brought in the Lok Sabha, in the 16th Lok Sabha, and then it was referred to a parliamentary standing committee. The 102nd parliamentary standing committee had given a number of about 42 recommendations were given by the parliamentary standing committee. Just to inform this house, out of those 42, 13 were accepted, 13 were part of the rules and regulations, 4 were already part of the surrogacy bill, and 11 were not accepted. Then the major points on which were not accepted, just for the knowledge of the members, there was a suggestion that altruistic surrogacy to be replaced by compensatory surrogacy, it was not accepted. Then also surrogacy procedure to be available to PIOs, OCIs, live-in couples, divorced women, widows, this was also not accepted. And couple to be married for 5 years to be reduced to 1 year. And also they suggested that the close relative should be removed. I will elaborate upon this later on when I answer the debate. Sir, just to summarize, the salient features of this bill are that it allows altruistic ethical surrogacy to the needy, infertile, married Indian couples, including NRIs. Then, when either or both members of the couple is suffering from proven infertility, then also when not for producing children for sale, prostitution, or any other form of exploitation, then this bill also prohibits commercial surrogacy or commercialization of surrogacy services, including sale, purchase of human gametes, oocytes and human embryo, trading in sale or purchase by way of giving payment, rewards, benefit, fees, remuneration or monetary incentives in cash to surrogate mothers or her dependents. So there is a leaner structure in the whole bill where there is a suggestion about a National Surrogacy Board, State Surrogacy Board, and appropriate authorities at the state and the UT level. The boards are for policy making. The appropriate authorities are the executive bodies which will implement the provisions of the Act. And there are enough provisions for appeal against order of implementing authority. And these surrogacy boards, the composition of the surrogacy boards, you must have read in this, it has, in fact, the women members of parliament, there are the three women members of parliament also, two are elected by the houses and all. They are representatives of the various relevant ministries, and there are representatives from all stakeholders, then experts. So it's a very, very detailed National Surrogacy Board and the State Surrogacy Boards. They are going to implement the whole thing. Sir, I would request the House, because it's the need of the hour, long awaited, being discussed and demanded in the Parliament also for almost a decade now, and it has been asked by the Supreme Court also, by the Law Commission also, and I think the way the surrogacy, illegal surrogacy clinics, etc., and so many, as I mentioned, over 2,000 foreign babies are born in this country through these more than 3,000 illegal surrogacy clinics. There is a strong need to regulate surrogacy in the country. After this bill was brought to the notice of the cabinet, it was referred to a group of ministers which was headed by the late Shri Sushma Swarajji, with all relevant ministers in that. I was also in that group as a science and technology minister at that time, and there were a lot of deliberations about that. It has been referred to the parliamentary standing committee also. Everyone has discussed, and the parliamentary standing committee has also discussed it with all the stakeholders, NGOs and everyone, and I think The bill, after having been passed by the Lok Sabha on two occasions in the last parliament, the last Lok Sabha, 16th Lok Sabha, it was passed there in December of 2018. But it could not come in this house because of paucity of time. Now also, in the last 5-6 months, it has already been passed by the Lok Sabha again after having gone back to the cabinet and then to the Lok Sabha. And now, after having been passed in the Lok Sabha, it has come back. It has come to the upper house, and I would request the members to deliberate and pass this bill, which is going to be a real game changer for the country.
Thank you. There is one amendment by Sri Trichu Siva for reference of the Surrogacy Regulation Bill 2019 as passed by Lok Sabha to a select committee of the Rajya Sabha. Name you have list you have given. Are you moving your amendment?
Moving, sir.
Names, please.
Names.
You can read up.
Through the lobby and it has gone to the notice.
The motion for consideration of the Surrogacy Regulation Bill 2019 as passed by Lok Sabha and the amendment moved thereto are now open for discussion.